So the Proton is already one of the most versatile and feature-packed semi-modulars we've ever done. But what if I was to tell you there was a whole other layer of control lurking beneath the surface? Yes, today we're checking out Proton's very own secret panel. And no need to worry, guys, there's no secret handshake or initiation rituals required to get this knowledge. All you're gonna need is this video or the manual. So yes, there is a whole bunch of extra control you can do on the fly directly from the synth without having to connect or open the app. Which, if you're neck deep in a creative session, is definitely a very useful thing to have. So let's go through each feature now, and I'll label each segment in the description so you can easily jump to and reference any specific part. So if we press and hold the VCO's corresponding range button, we can change the sub-oscillator's waveform. So I'll just solo oscillator 1, then I'll solo the sub-oscillator so we can clearly hear it, and now we can use the LFO control here to select each waveform. So we've got a sine wave, there's a triangle, sawtooth, and then you've got square wave. And to exit, you simply press and hold the range button again. And to change VCO2, it's the same process. We just use the range button of VCO2 instead. Here we can choose between a switch or a fade for the VCO waveforms by pressing and holding the corresponding VCO's range button and then the power button. And if the power button is lit, it's set to fade, and if it's off, it's set to switch. So we can disable the tune controls here by pressing and holding the corresponding VCO's range button, and then we can press the sync button to disable. And you'll notice the VCO's LED disables as well. And of course, if you want to turn it back on, simply press the sync button again and the LED will illuminate. So a useful setting here when you want to create drones and don't require MIDI input to a VCO or both VCOs. So to disable, press and hold the corresponding VCO's range button and then press the retrig button in the envelope. And as we can hear, the MIDI input has been disabled on this VCO, signified by the lit retrig button. So here we can set the split point for the paraphonic mode's last note priority. So when we set the split point, oscillator 1 will play the notes below the split, and oscillator 2 will play the notes above it. So to do this, simply press and hold the range button, then choose your split point with the keyboard, and then simply press the mode 1 button. And to illustrate this, you can hear on VCO 1, I've got a hollow bass tone, and then a more raspy tone here on VCO 2. And these are triggered by the respective sides of the split point. Now, LFO key tracking is definitely a great way to add more variance to your modulation, and it's also really easy to set up. So first off, I've patched LFO 1 into the pitch CV of each oscillator. And as you can hear, currently there's no actual key tracking of the pitch mod. So let's set that up. So first off, we'll set the bass note for the key tracking. And as we're using LFO 1, we'll press and hold VCO 1's range button, then play the note we want to set, and then press the one shot button. Okay, so now that's done, we now need to set the depth amount so we can hear the effect. And to do that, you just need to press and hold the one shot button, and then we can use the LFO knob to set the amount. So there we go, now we can clearly hear the higher notes have a faster modulation speed. And I obviously set it up quite obnoxiously here, just so we could really hear it. But it's a really nice function to be able to get nuance and variance in your patches. So the filters are already controlled by the LFO modulation, but you can also add a second modulation source independently to each filter. So to do this, we press and hold the filter's mode button, and now we can use the LFO control to change the modulation source. So by default, it's set to none, and then you have the option of using MIDI velocity as a source, or the mod wheel, or you can use aftertouch. And obviously that was filter 1, and if you want to change the filter 2 source, you follow the same process, but press the mode 2 button instead. And like the VCOs, you can also set the LFOs to switch or fade between its waveforms. So we can simply press and hold the one shot button here, and then press the power button to select between fade or switch. And then to change it on LFO 2, we follow the same process, but instead pressing and holding the retrig button. And now if I press the shift button to view LFO 2, you can see the waveforms are fading. So a really cool feature here is that we can sync the LFOs to the incoming MIDI clock. So to do that on LFO 1, we press and hold the one shot button again, and press the sync button so it lights up. And now the LFO is synced to MIDI clock, and the rate control will change the clock divisions. And to do that on LFO 2, it's the same idea, but instead we press and hold the retrig button. So to set the note priority, we press and hold the sync button, and then we can use the mode 1 button to select the note priority for monophonic mode. So the top LED sets it to highest note priority, the middle sets it to last note priority, and then the lower LED sets it to lowest priority. And then the same applies for the mode 2 button, but that sets the priority for the paraphonic mode. So here we can set up the source for the assign output CV connection on the patch bay. So to do this, we press and hold the sync button, and now we can use the LFO control to select a source. So by default, it's set to oscillator 1, then you've got oscillator 2, velocity, mod wheel, and lastly, aftertouch. So here we can set the destination for the assign input on the patch bay. So press and hold the mode button in the wave folder, and now we can again use the LFO control to set it up. So in default, it's set to none. Then you have oscillator 1 CV, oscillator 2 CV, both oscillator 1 and 2 CV at the same time, VCF 1, And then you've got VCF2 and lastly VCF1 and 2 simultaneously. And following on from that, we can set the depth for the assign-in by pressing and holding the wave mode button again. And then press the shift button in the filter. And then we can use the LFO control to set the depth. So to turn on the re-trigger mode for the ASR envelopes, we press and hold the sync button and then turn it on using the re-trig button. And here we can turn on polychain mode by pressing and holding the sync button and then pressing the power button. So when the power LED is on, it means polychaining is active. And of course, when it's off, it means it's off. And the last setting here, we can do a full recalibration of the synth without having to power cycle it. So simply press and hold the power and ASR re-trigger button for more than 2 seconds, and then the unit will recalibrate.